You know who that is? That's Miss Cocky. What about Bukaki? I don't even know what that is. I hear people say it. See this point?
Built like a brick!
Dude, pretty quick. Let's go. Dude, I got a cool idea. Welcome back to another episode of Finding Bass on the Bass Pro Tour. We have a unique situation. We have to keep our boats at this house while we stay at the other house. So there's Zach's boat. Here's my boat. Come on, let's go. Stay tuned. It's going to be fun. Hit that subscribe button, like, and follow along. And as always, catch a bass.
I don't want to live life fast or die too young. Die too young. 100 miles per hour, I might crash because a good die young. Yeah, a good die young. Push it to the limit, I can't go no more. Red light, no way, I'm coming back home.
Where will our first Murray bass come from? I'm not looking for them on the screen right now. When you're shallow, you're just fishing. Oh yeah, we get in the flow now. There's all kinds of bait in here, dude. Made two stops already. It's 8 a.m. actually, right? Dang, it's crazy. This Eastern time zone is kind of wild. But back up a creek. No bites, a lot of shad. I came back in here in 2021 and never didn't have any bites either, but I was like, come try it. Different, 2 years later, a little earlier in the year, fish should be spawning. Checked my juice herring spawn point this morning, no bites. So, but the water this morning was 63. I think. By the end of the week, it's gonna be pushing 70 because we got a lot of 80 degree days, some warmer nights. Something's gonna come alive, and I hope it's me. He come off. That's two bites up there. Caught me sleeping.
Oh, they're schooling.
They're on the other side of the point. Big one. Might be a striper. I'm guessing it might be a striper because he's just running. It's not even that big and they're this strong. Imagine hooking a big one. Look at it, down its throat. Old Lake Murray special. A striper guide. Now that you know what they are, you just don't negotiate with them and you don't fly them, you know, you just like fight them and say, you're mine. You're mine. Oh my, this thing's freaking big. It's moving some water. This is fun. I don't care who you are, dude. Oh my God. This is a big one.
Still running this herring spawn this morning, loaded with some stripers right there. That was a good time, but it's not a target species. We gotta catch some bass.
I love you like la 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 la.
First cast with it.
He hammered it. Tunk.
Little bath.
Biggin. Might have figured something out here, boys. Might have figured something out here. I mean, 3-pounder about. Pre-spawn. See the belly?
Dude, dumped it.
Hey, I'm about to fire up a loud-ass two-stroke. Both fish are going to be scared.
And we're going to only be the first of several.
I'm pretty sure it's not going to matter.
Hey, you caught something. You caught a lure.
You're a very odd person.
We'll tackle warehouse order real fast, man. I only have a couple packs of what I just got bid on. And there's a lot of marinas and docks here, so if that becomes a bite, I'll just run out of them real fast. So we're gonna get them.
Dude, those two were actually paired up courting. The male was bumping that female, steering, like trying to steer towards that bed. Pretty cool. Come here, sugar. I got these good eggs for you. I'll marinate them eggs. Let me get them eggs, sugar. Well, that's a dang stud. Oh, what a stud. That's a big one. It's right there. Is he gonna get it? I think he's hatching right there, actually. He's coming out of his cocoon right there. That's really cool. We just watched a butterfly hatch. Save water, drink margs. Roll Tide. But yeah, the key ingredient has some girls in bikinis on the docks. You for sure gonna catch them. Dude, a massive amount of bait back here. Massive. I caught a 1¾-pound bass. That's a masterpiece. Let's let him go. Hooray! We caught the bass. Now, I caught him here last time in this pocket, and I was like, if I can't come in here and get a bite, I'm concerned. So less concerned than I was a minute ago. But, I mean, he's still a little one. He's got friends. Hopefully in low places. They were like Senkos.
You're done. You're done. You're done. That's a fat one. Coming here to spawn, about 3-pounder. Nice, thick one.
That's a nice one.
You take my picture with it?
Yeah.
Got some bucks in here. Maybe some females will come by the tournament. Oh my God, he choked it. He got my wacky rig. Pike!
Well, we picked up the old wacky rig. It's always been my game plan to do that if I haven't found anything and struggling a little bit. Like, let's just see if I can actually catch one with a wacky rig, and it didn't take too long. I've caught 3 or 4 now with it. Found a nice little pocket back there. Has some up in it. Best looking water I've seen shallow so far, so kind of exciting. Caught one on a glide bait, but it was a pike. It was fun.
Hey, buddy! Nice to meet you. I'm Ryan. He said, I'll take a ball. You want the ball? You want the ball? I can befriend any dog.
It got off.
We like to see this many dots. Those are all bedding bass. Delicious bedding bass. I'm bald. Yeah, bedding bass. Problem being group B is they might have already had their jaw jack come group B. Hopefully group A sucks and can't catch any bass. I doubt that. I already know that ain't gonna happen. Well, let's wrap up day one. Start off trying to find that elusive herring bite, and I found it with some mega stripers. Caught a bunch of stripers. I had one bass chase the Seville, and then I had another striper. So I don't think it's the deal right now. Excuse me, I'm tired. Fished for 12 hours a day. And then saw a few on beds, caught a few on a swim bait, caught a good one on a swim bait, and then had another one knock a mag draft. Went a long time without nothing, pulled out the wacky rig to see if it worked. It worked. And then started looking beds, running beds, and found several beds. Just being group B, you don't know what's gonna get picked over, so we're gonna try to keep trying to find a pattern. Stay tuned.
Got one. I'm washing, come out and get it. That was cool. That didn't take long. Good fish too. That was cool. That was cool. Second, third cast with a square bill. He lurched out and was like, yum, yum, yum. But two something pounder. Square bill could be the deal up here. We'll see. It just looks like just that power fishing shallow cover. What's so cool about it is I actually got to watch them come out and eat it. Alright. Just let them go. Digging too. Look at that giant. Look at this giant. He choked it. Six pounder. It's gone. He couldn't have ate any deeper. He's bleeding. I gotta get him over the water. That's a big one. Ready? Look at that beast. Lurking off into the deep. That's two good ones up here so far, man. Little tree. She was on it, probably spawning. Swim jig by it, saw her come out. All about adjustments, man. I've been trying to figure out something I can keep in my hand, but they didn't want to come up on a buzzbait. I was like, let me swim my little swimmy swim jig in there. My little swimmy swim jig. And they ate my swimmy swim jig. She choked it. They can't eat it. I almost hate it when they eat it that deep because it hurts them. Let's see if we can find more places because we just get that couple bites up here. We still can't, I don't know what to say about that. I mean, we got to get some more bites to make it, to verify. Go to some other places. This is a pretty cool little area though. I'm going to go idle towards the back and just see what's back there.
Junk fishing.
I don't f***ing know that I'm gonna catch one back here. Yeah, think it would've f***ing happened already.
Well, I just smoked a tree. Anyway, I was interrupted by a tree, fished all the way up this creek after I caught like a 5-pounder in the mouth of it. No bites in the back of the creek, so we're gonna keep exploring up here. You can kind of see this is how far I went off the map. Look, this is how far I went. No bites. Much lightning going on, boys and girls. We got to get out of here. If we run south about a mile, we'll be out of the craziness, but it's going to sit on us for a while. We're going to go back to the truck and make a decision from there. We got to let it pass anyway.
You weren't joking. Look at this storm.
It's 4 o'clock. I've caught 2 bass. They were both this morning. One was a 2-pounder. One was a 5.5. And they were both up river, and then I couldn't get another bite up river. Then we had the lightning storm. Then we hang out at the bait shop. Then we tried to catch them on buzz bait for 2 hours and didn't catch anything. Then we took out and came to the main ramp, and I found 2 bedding bass and nothing else. We gonna keep grinding. But the wind's gassing about 40. 40.
Said, I wanna jump in the bass's mouth. Put it in his mouth. I mean, if they're not shallow now, you gotta figure with this warm up, they're gonna flood shallow. You gotta figure, right? Like, come on.
Sweet zone. Every lake is a Goldilocks zone for whatever pattern that you're running, and we haven't seen any bedders. Like, let me see, basically five six miles from the dam. After that, I don't really see much, and the water's colder. One of either two things has happened. They've already spawned and they're just vacated, which I don't believe because there's no fry garters or nothing up shallow. Or two, they're about to come to the hill with this warm up. Who knows if they come in time, but we'll see. That wraps up this practice video. And it's kind of cool because we delayed the outro and we just finished day one and day two of competition. And I ended up catching all my fish sight fishing. Had an incredible day one. Had a 6.11 for my first bass. Had caught another 6.2, ended up with 19 pounds, 6 ounces on day one. I ended up catching 15 pounds today, which got me, I finished in 11th place in my group, which got me into the knockout round. So, hit the like, hit the subscribe, and let's see how this tournament shakes out. I'm thinking it takes 17.5 to make the top 10 tomorrow. I think we can do that.